Viva the day 14. It is minus two, not 20 like it was yesterday, minus two, and very overcast. There's no blue sky for me, not even a little. Well, I guess there's a little patch of it over here. Okay, I can stare at the blue patch and pretend it's sunny. Look, blue sky, really there is. Anyways, I'm in terrible pain. I'm in a good mood, but I'm in terrible pain. Yeah. My back went out again last night. I rolled over and it popped, just like it did when I sat on the toilet the other day. And it popped really loudly. There was a feeling of release, and it hurt really bad. Yeah. And it's been hurting really bad ever since. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't. I got some canned tomatoes. I can eat those, I guess. Vegetables are easier to cook up as well. So, just fire them into some boiling water for a couple of minutes and you're done, right? So, basically, you just want to thaw out the frozen vegetables, bring them up to a boil, and then drain them. That's it. That's all you need to do with them. If you get the water boiling first, that's the best idea. And you put them in there, and you hit them for like 30 seconds, and 30, 40 seconds. Yep. Strain them, and away you go, right? You don't want to overcook them, because you'll ruin the vegetables. You'll screw the taste, like my mother did every damn time. They lost color, they lost flavor, they lost nutrients. When you overcook them, that's exactly what happens. They're worthless. You might as well be eating cotton candy, because it's about as good for you. There's no sugar in the vegetables, but there's no nutritional value when you overcook them like that. So, yeah. Gibbers, best thing for corn on the cob is not to boil it. It is to microwave it. You cut the ends off, leave the sheath on. You put it in the microwave for a couple of minutes, and if that's not long enough, put it in for another minute, but anyways, you got to experiment with your microwave, because they're all different, right? My last one that I had was 2 minutes, and it worked fine. And then you pull off the sheath, and you eat it. It's good that way, and it really is nice. There's a lot of bite, a lot of flavor. When you boil it, you lose flavor, of course, and whatnot. People tend to overboil them chronically, so, the prompt for the day is your earliest memory. Now, I wasn't in school yet, so I wasn't in kindergarten yet, so I was less than 6 years old, but I don't know how old I was. I have no idea. I have two really early memories from when I was a wee little kid. No, I have three very early memories. But my earliest is I'm under the porch, back porch. And there's a stray cat under there, and it's had kittens, okay? And it's letting me play with kittens. It's not killing me for playing with his kittens for some reason or another. But my entire life, animals have let me do things that other people wouldn't get away with. So it's just the way it is, and I have no idea why. It's always has been. I'll go into more of that later if I remember. But yeah, anyways, I'm under there playing with the kittens, and I fell asleep, right? Because little kids fall asleep quite easily, and I fell asleep. So my mom's looking for me, and she's going absolutely nuts looking for me, right? So she thinks I've been kidnapped or I've run away or wandered off and been killed or something. She's ready to phone the police and have them look for me. She's screaming, "David, David," And I remember her sounding upset, and I'm like, "Here I is," Literally, that's what I said. "Here I is," and yeah, Mom never let me forget this. She retold the story many, many times, but yes, I actually do remember it. I even remember the shape of the hole and that allowed you to get under the porch and all that stuff. So yeah. Anyways, then there's my chicken. I played with that for a long time. I don't know. I got it when I was two. It was a chicken, rooster on wheels, I should say. I keep calling it my chicken, but it was a rooster. It was a rooster on wheels that you pulled on a string behind you, right? And I played with that thing for a long time. For a long time. And I remember playing with the chicken. I love that thing a lot for years. I don't know what happened to the chicken. I wish I still had the chicken. I do. I really do wish I had it. But my mom had this thing where if we stopped playing with toys, she donated them to charity. So as soon as I stopped playing with it for a couple of months, it was gone. That's the way it is. We didn't keep things like that. We didn't keep them. Not at all. There's a lot of things I wish I still had, like my 12-inch G.I. Joe. Yeah, and the other memory that I remember from way back before I was in kindergarten was the encyclopedias were on the bottom shelf of the bookshelf. There was a bookshelf in the living room. Here's the back wall, which is the north wall. And there's a bookshelf all the way up and down, all the way across the wall. And then over here, there's the entrance to the kitchen. And over here, there's not a bookshelf, there's just a wall. The bookshelf with the encyclopedias on it, I would take the encyclopedias out and then I would lay on the shelf. And I would take a nap on the shelf, and my mom would get pissy that I took all the encyclopedias out. But I kept doing it, even though she gave me shit every time, right? I did it over and over and over again. I was one of those demon children that just did shit. Doesn't care about the consequences. I would do shit. Even if I got a spanking, I would do shit anyways. I was a demon child. I really was. Spanking me did nothing, It was useless. But they kept doing it. So they kept thinking it was gonna help. It never did. Okay, there's more blue sky now. Maybe I'm gonna get blue sky. I doubt it because it looks really dark in the distance here. Past the church looks really black. Finished Fallout. Thursday, I watched, or Friday, I watched two episodes. Saturday, I watched the other six. It was epic. Oh my God, that's on Amazon Prime. If you have Amazon Prime, Fallout is a really good series. There's only 8 hours of it to watch. Series nowadays aren't like when I was younger. They're not. You only get 8 or 10, 6, 8 or 10 shows, and then the season is done. When I was a kid, you got like 23 of the damn things, 20, 23 episodes in the year. in a series, and that would be 23 weeks you would see the same series. Then it would go into reruns. That's, you know, when before streaming, of course, the internet didn't exist, right? So, yeah, that's why when you watch old shows on streaming, it takes forever to watch them because the seasons were so long. That being said, I just watched something I haven't seen since the 70s. I do believe, don't quote me, but I do believe this show was from 1974. It's called Ark 2, A-R-K space I-I. Roman numeral for two, Ark 2. And it's basically this giant RV thing. And it was. It was a really big vehicle that they built for the show. And it was a mobile science center. And the scientists, people, highly trained young people, that's literally what it says. Highly trained young people, even though the one looks to be about 35. but he's a young person, even though he's like 35, right? Anyways, the other two are young. The one's in their the woman's in her 20s by the looks of her. And, you know, at the time, they're old people now. They're dead, one or the other. Anyways, and then a teenage boy who didn't speak very good English, if you ask me. He seemed to have a speech impediment, I think, or I think he was trying to fake a Mexican accent. One or the other, because he didn't speak right. He either had a speech impediment or he was trying to fake the Mexican accent that he had. One or the other. I can't tell. So, yeah. But anyways, they go around the wastelands after the fall of civilization, you know, the apocalypse. And my nose is stuffy again and leaky. Anyways, they're going around after the apocalypse trying to fix society. And it's not the greatest show in the world. I romanticized it, of course, and I thought it was awesome back then. I really did. Even though there was only 15 episodes, and after 15 episodes, it was canceled. They didn't do seasons in advance back then. They would do it. Literally a couple of weeks in advance, and that's it. They would be filming 2 weeks ahead of schedule release. So they would be filming while you were watching. So they were still filming the series. So, yeah. Anyways, I didn't like it nearly as much as I did when I was a kid, but it was okay. I can see why I liked it when I was a kid. Unlike the Star Lost, I can't see why I liked that as a kid. I can't. It was terrible. I mean, it was absolutely terrible. This was acceptable. It's a pass. I'd give it a 6 out of 10. They're supposed to be highly intelligent, highly trained people, but they keep getting kidnapped by the scavengers and stuff like that. So, you know, like literally every show, somebody kidnaps one of them, and it's an obvious trap, and it's obvious what's going to happen to them. And you're like, yeah, they're so intelligent, you know. But yeah, it was a good show. I'm glad I watched it again. Suburban Rider, Chuck, was telling me on Facebook that they had a full-time mechanic to make the damn car run, the RV thing, the Ark, run. Because it was a piece of junk, basically, I guess, and it needed maintenance constantly to just get through the scenes of them driving it here and there in the shows. Yevers, I seem to vaguely remember something about that from many years ago. Hearing something like that from many years ago, but I can't be certain. Yeah, you know. Anyways, Fallout looked familiar to me. Fallout looked familiar to me, and I don't know why, because I know I haven't seen it, but yeah, it was very familiar all the way through. But I get that a lot with TV shows and movies, where it's like I've seen it, even though it's just been released. You know, I get that a lot. So yeah. But Fallout is evidently true to the game storyline. I have never played the game, of course, because I don't play games. Anyways, it was very exciting. It was a very exciting TV series. The acting was very, very good. The special effects, the CGI, and the suits that they were wearing, and all that stuff were really, really cool. They were really well done. Disney, there's no way in hell Disney could have got this level of special effects. There's no way. Disney, I find, is sadly lacking in special effects. And with all the money they have, you would think they would do it right, but they never do. I'm going to give I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10, a perfect 10 out of 10. I am, because it's just that good. It's one of the best TV series that I've ever seen in my life. One of the top 50, anyways, that I've seen in my entire life. It's just that good. Probably top 20, so yeah. Anyways, speaking of Disney, I've seen the trailers, ouch, for the new season of Doctor Who, which it comes out in November, I think. I'm not certain. I don't remember when they said it was coming out. But anyways, it looks like the special effects are shit. They had a scene where the TARDIS is flying in, and it's like, oh my god, that is really bad CGI. I mean, really bad CGI. You could super tell that it's CGI, and it's really not good. I've literally seen people do backyard movies that they've done with their friends. I've seen more than a few of those in my life. I've seen where it's literally a bunch of people doing it for a hobby, where the effects were better, the CGI was better. So, you know, there's no excuse for this. There isn't, but there's Disney for you. Anyways, this is 18 minutes and change already. Fallout, very worth it, very worth it. I'm really super not getting into Star Trek Discovery, the final season, season 5. I'm super not getting into it. I'm like 3 episodes in, and I'm like, this is really terrible. I'm not liking it at all, but I'm such a Star Trek fan that I will watch the whole thing. It's just that I'm not liking it. I'm not. The only really good part was so far is Saru being really, really in love with the Vulcan. They're not Vulcans, are they? They call themselves something else, and I don't remember what they're called. But anyways, the Romulans and the Vulcans have joined forces again. They've become one species again, one people again. That is, yeah. And they're called something else. So yeah, she's one of those. But yeah, that's the only really good part so far. The rest of it is just, I can't. The storylines for the first 3 episodes sucked. The acting was acceptable only. Like I say, with the exception of Saru, the person that plays Saru, who did a bang-up job of it. Really, really he did. And yeah. Anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day. Keep smiling, yo. Wow, this went long.